right now. It's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Storm Watch here at the Weather Channel. I'm Paul Emmick. We're here to take a look at some very stormy conditions still across the Midwest in around Mackinac Island or Mackinac right now, Mackinac County and the UP of Michigan. Severe thunderstorm warning and many across Wisconsin as well as into Iowa. Those are some of the stormiest spots. We'll look at those. First, we'll begin taking a look at the tropics as we begin with our tropical update. In a moment, we'll look at some of the severe weather, including Saline County, Nebraska, also Chippewa County into eastern upper Michigan. In the UP, still a very stormy time and place. Now, in the tropics, not a lot going on usually during the month of June. It's not one of the climatologically favored areas we often see development. Now, really, you know, we just start to see a few into June, but of course it becomes a lot more likely on in toward August, September, and October. But you look to see where the tracks have been, where they often develop in June, very close to land. Even sometimes you'll see a big batch of convection. A few years ago, we had a big cluster of storms that moved across Louisiana over a weekend, pushed out over the water, took on tropical characteristics, then came back in as a hurricane named Danny. So we'll have to look closer to land and not so much further out. Now, into July, upper-level conditions becoming a little less volatile toward the survival of a system making the move, say from the Cape Verde region, kind of moving across from Africa, the southern coast there, and moving on. Some of the principal tracks getting a little further away from land masses, including parts of the Caribbean that might be a little more active into July. But again, usually in June, most develop very close to land. Look at the big picture of things here about the past 24 hours or so. As you look on toward the Gulf, not a lot going on for the Gulf region right now at all. Again, a very quiet time across the Gulf and the Caribbean. Nothing really looking at prime for development. Little bit of active weather, just a little wave kind of kicking through the windwards, but not a lot expected from that. Across the Pacific, not much happening, although continue to watch off the Pacific some storms that are popping up just because it's a little more favorable. The conditions are pretty ripe now for something to develop. In the Pacific, very common to see storms this time of the year, and out of the question, we could have a classified system. Anything that does pop up should be fairly slow to develop, but in a few days, we could indeed have a system off the Pacific coast. Here's what's happening, the current weather coast to coast. Across parts of upstate New York, a little bit wet, also some rain into Florida. A few sprinkles, a little drizzle here and there, including around Colorado, including in toward Denver Metro. May see a little drizzle here for a while. Across the Midwest, so that's where the problems are most noticeable. Still very volatile atmosphere in place. We have sufficient lift, we have enough moisture, we have enough instability, plus proper upper-level support. We're destined for a situation with severe weather chances. Wisconsin, still many spots across Wisconsin getting stormy. And I mentioned a moment ago, UP of Michigan stormy too. UP, parts of Wisconsin, also a bit of Minnesota, a little bit of a tornado watch still in effect. Wisconsin, Illinois, Iowa, even northwestern Missouri, and in Nebraska, severe thunderstorm watch here. Of course, many conditions favorable for severe weather, like incredible wind and also sizable hail. Now think about this, too. Some of the storms that are pushing through, like the UP, moving 50 or 60 miles per hour. Even some of these cells in the 30 to 40 mile an hour range moving across bits of Iowa. Things are really pretty action-packed. I mentioned Mackinac County, severe thunderstorm warning. We got some big storms in Marquette. It's kind of moved on to our north and east. Still some soaking rain, though. still very stormy at times across Wisconsin. Around the Twin Cities, quiet, but in toward Eau Claire and even Rhinelander, a few storms in our region. Look at this line right there, kind of collapsing in a hurry. Kind of interesting to watch the last few minutes. Kind of fueled up and then kind of, look at it, kind of getting together, getting stormy, and then last few minutes starting to collapse a little bit, pushing into western Illinois. Kind of interesting to see things fall apart. We're away from our daytime heating by quite a bit. Pretty common you see storms weaken a bit. It's a little bit stormy around Cedar Rapids, a little longer. Mostly soaking rain, though. Northwestern parts of Missouri, even across Kansas, some additional storms. Some in Nebraska. A little bit wet into parts of Florida. And across the western U.S., I mentioned just a few showers here and there. May see a little drizzle a bit longer in toward Denver. More on the active weather of our night next after local forecast.
So what do you play?
Tenor sax.
I play a bad guitar myself.
Yeah?
I mean bad, in a bad sense.
As long as you enjoy it.
You make a good living?
Yeah. I do what I love. In the 43 countries.
43?
Yeah.
You want to take next year off?
No, I know you, Bob. I know you're serious.
Check this out. I'm going to lunch.
Well, it's not like we didn't anticipate this. Listen, let me talk to your accountant about the tax implications. We'll go from there.
Yeah, that stock sector could have gone up or down hard. It was just too risky for you.
Thanks for the heads up on that one.
Sure. So how's your dad doing?
Well, that's what I really wanted to talk to you about.
Hunter ceiling fan can cut your summer cooling costs up to 40%. And it's so quiet, the only sound you'll hear is your electric bill dropping. Hunter, silence is golden. It's our quietest, most powerful motor ever, designed to help you save up to 40% on summer cooling bills. The patented Air Max motor, only in Hunter ceiling fans. Hunter, quiet for life.
My doctor says I'm healthier than he is. I swim every day.
If you suffer from arthritis pain, speak to your doctor.
The lake is good for your soul.
Tylenol arthritis pain, as effective as the most prescribed arthritis pain medicine, but much gentler to your stomach.
When I swim, I'm free.
Tylenol arthritis pain. And to help promote joint flexibility, try Aflexa, a glucosamine supplement. Live by it. The Weather Channel is brought to you by this cable or satellite provider. You can also get reliable forecasts from the Weather Channel through this newspaper.
Think you've got what it takes to go on location with the Weather Channel crew? If so, join the Weather Quest adventure. Send us a video about your most incredible weather experience, and you could win an adventure in Hawaii. A quest for excitement. A quest for adventure. A quest for weather. Want to go? Log on weather.com for details or watch Atmospheres Wednesdays at 8 on the Weather Channel. The Weather Quest adventure.
Your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
Thank you.
Welcome to Weather Center here at the Weather Channel. My name is Paul Emmick, and together we'll take a look at what's going to be confronting us as we head into our Tuesday. Looking at some wet weather across the Midwest, could it be stormy, and even as the chances of more severe weather, too. A system not moving that fast, where some of the cells are moving pretty fast on through, but as long as that focusing mechanism hangs nearby, expect the weather to be a bit on the rough side here for a while. Northeast, nothing but nice. New York City, Boston, Hartford, Providence, Philly, D.C., Baltimore. Couldn't ask for a better day for the commute. Let's see if we can ask for a wetter day elsewhere. Well, pretty quiet for many parts of the country here for the overnight hours. On the daytime, though, and overnight, still stormy across the Midwest. Do indeed expect it to stay that way, too. Between now and mid-morning, the roughest place to be could be across the Midwest. Even beyond the mid-morning, the system may progress just a little bit further. It may give us a severe weather threat. Kansas City, St. Louis might still deal with the storms, even some rough weather in toward Detroit. So it makes sense to stay tuned to the Weather Channel throughout the day, especially in the afternoon when things could get pretty volatile right through the middle of the country. Okay, let's look briefly, at the day that was our Monday. Pretty hot day for Denver, 91. Warm, too, 108 toward Phoenix. Pretty hot day around Vegas, out around L.A. We had 84 here today. That's pretty warm. That's right downtown the Civic Center, too. 75 to San Diego. A little cooler for the Northwest. As far as departures, where we often fall, a little cooler across the northern plains. A bit above our average, especially in toward San Francisco with our 82 today. That was what I call pretty warm. Very hot, really, around Chicagoland. We topped out at 91, 83 for New York City, 84 to Boston, around 89 downtown Miami, and even a 94 toward Tampa. That's a big picture with the temperatures, including big heat across the Midwest. A little bit of cooler air back behind it. Of course, that makes sense. Cold front moving on, cooler air back behind it. Big air kind of pumped up, moisture-rich atmosphere just ahead of it. Looking toward Alaska, 36 to Barrow, 67 to Juneau, around 62 toward Anchorage. Looking at Hawaii, 82 for Lihue, 84 to Honolulu, Kahului 82, and Hilo on the Big Island 76. Let's talk of quakes for a moment. A 2.8 magnitude was 22 miles south-southeast of Calexico, California. Also a 2.7 magnitude north-northwest of the town of Big Bear Lake. Further north, a report of a 2.2 magnitude that was just east-southeast of Coso Junction, and another 2.3 in the same region as well. Further north, a 2.6 was just east of Maupin, Oregon. And several reported across Alaska, all in the range of a 2 magnitude, so nothing incredibly strong, and no specifics available in the location, but obviously one in the south central region and several in the southern region as well. In the morning, we're not really going to see the benefit of precip in the northwest. That will be a few days away. Could see a few storms popping up here and there across the interior west, but for most of us, a pretty quiet Tuesday. Looking at specifics, kind of a cloud or two toward the start at San Diego. Also some clouds to the Civic Center. We'll push those back toward the beaches as the day goes on. Pretty cool start around the Bay Area, driving the Bay Bridge, the Golden Gate in the morning. Temperature's okay, about 52, and a fine finish. Still fairly warm, and very warm, too, towards Sacramento. Of course, the heat here, when it's this hot, it does put even a further strain on an already a troubling electrical situation. Of course, you know what this is all about. We could use the cooler temperatures to be nice, but when you have this kind of heat, and we know, we kick the air conditioners on, that kind of thing, and consumption does become quite an issue. And I mean, it's going to be a while, too, before we get some cooler air across California, because temperatures are warming up quite a bit. Like I said, consumption goes up, and we could see more problems like throughout Monday across the state of California. Northwest, a few clouds. Otherwise, not that bad for the afternoon. Long I-5, 75 out around the Space Needle, even 82 toward Portland. Let's look at the western U.S. specifically. I mentioned the storm prospects across the middle. A chance of severe weather anywhere from the UP, across parts of Illinois, bits of Missouri, even Kansas and Nebraska, and for a somewhat stormy night. Heaviest rainfall will be through this region as well. Northeast, maybe a few sprinkles in upstate, but honestly not that big of an ordeal for most of us. Little rain may linger, a few sprinkles into Florida might add up just a smidgen in South Florida. Across the midday hours, many spots could pick up well in excess of an inch. Anywhere from the UP, southward into bits of Missouri, to the western U.S., not a lot of precip really to add up. Here's the morning, pretty quiet for the west, pretty quiet in the northeast thanks to our high pressure, nice one, New York City, Boston, Hartford, Providence, Philly, D.C., Baltimore, throughout even Virginia Beach, Carolinas, nice toward Charleston, fine on the battery, Hilton Head looking good, even fine toward the Outer Banks, into parts of low country, looking good, into Florida, fine day, pretty warm though. Big storms though, firing up even on toward Kansas City and St. Louis, could be stormy during the day. Some storms toward Chicago, eventually toward Detroit. May see some lingering rainfall in Might even get dampened a bit in toward Cleveland. Here's a look at the heavy rainfall again, and here's a look at that heavy heat across the southwest, but some cooling across the northern plains. Look at the impact of all this on our week coming up in the weekly planner in just a few moments. Please stay tuned.
I'm a Gold Bond guy. Ordinary body powders don't work for me, but Gold Bond body powder is medicated to work as hard as I do. Gold Bond powder keeps me cool, dry, and itch-free.
Gold Bond body powder, medicated to work as hard as you do.
Oh. You've never felt relief that lasts like this before.
It's amazing.
The revolutionary new Icy Hot Patch. Concentrated pain relief that's icy first to dull the pain, then hot to relax it away for hours of relief.
It's fantastic how long it works.
What will you ask me?
I've been waiting to talk to you.
Oh, bless you.
Because I know you got something to tell me.
I see a card of police documentation and then someone watching you very closely. All right?
I know exactly who you're talking about.
Yeah.
And I can't believe that you can see that.
Who are all these other older men around you? Do you have a lot of men in your family?
Yes, my grandmother has 6 sons.
You're really afraid at night, honey.
I am.
Yeah.
Four nights
you've been scared to death.
Yeah.
All right.
Really? I can't sleep at night. Well, I can't believe you knew that.
You don't trust him, so that's a problem.
Yeah.
Honey, I'm on my way.
Oh, my goodness.
You hear me? On my way probably means about 2.5 hours.
Oh, you got it. You got it.
Are you afraid that someone is keeping a secret from you? Call now for a free tarot reading and discover the truth today.
Miss Cleo, you are the best.
Call 1-800-407-1075.
Right now, it's your local forecast on the Weather Channel.
is weekly planner time now at the Weather Channel. We'll kick back and take a look at changes the next 7 days could bring. Across the Midwest, we might want a bit of a change. Still way too stormy for the overnight hours. Still very stormy. And even throughout the daytime, could kick it up in the afternoon around Kansas City. Even St. Louis could be rather stormy. Northwest, not much yet, but we will get some wet weather opportunities our way. A little rain may skirt through parts of upstate New York. A few lingering showers into parts of Florida. Those are fading away pretty fast. That's what's happening overnight in the short term. What about more of a long-term look? Let's take a look at what's going on now, beginning with a look at our day here on our Tuesday. Yeah, we'll take a look at Tuesday now and look at some of the storms. Scattered strong to severe weather around Detroit, even toward Toledo. Parts of Indiana might be a bit on the stormy side. Still across parts of Kansas, many spots even into Oklahoma could be in for rough weather along that front, that focusing mechanism kind of moving southward and eastward. You get it sliding on. As it continues to make its progress, it's running into a very sticky air mass. There's sufficient lift, enough moisture, and enough instability, plus proper upper-level support. Specifically through this region, we could be in for very rough weather, looking at a potentially very volatile day. So stay tuned to the Weather Channel for complete information. Again, this does include Detroit and even southward toward Indy. Might see some storms in West Kentucky, southern Indiana, too, like in toward Evansville. Scattered storms on the Gulf Coast, a few in the low country along the Atlantic coast, too. Not much toward the northwest just yet. As far as the rainfall, we could see some Wednesday. Might see just a few showers into parts of California. A little wet relief, but not a lot. Just a few scattered storms. Otherwise, rainfall, Kansas City, St. Louis, even on toward Denver. Indianapolis, across parts of Ohio, even kind of scooting in the northeast. Might see some rain upstate New York, Albany, and Buffalo. That's on Wednesday, but in a Thursday, a little better chance of wetter weather for us. New York City, Boston, Hartford, Providence, Philly, D.C., and Baltimore. Throughout the Carolinas, even Virginia Beach, then on Atlanta, Birmingham, Jackson, Mississippi, even New Orleans and Houston might see at least a chance of a few scattered storms. A little wet weather into Florida, around Miami, Tampa, and Orlando, and more rain across the Midwest, Chicago, Detroit, and Milwaukee. Kind of a heads up toward that. We've been waiting for the wet weather in the Northwest. Guess what? Finally, the chance arrives. Afternoon on Thursday, might even see some lingering showers into Friday. Some rain across the northern plains, wet across bits of Texas in a few locations, southeastern seaboard and the northeast. We can see more rain lingering for Friday on toward Philly and toward Boston, New York City, Hartford, and Providence, too. Maybe planning on leaving the office early, heading toward the Cape or Nantucket, even toward the Hamptons. Might see a few showers into Saturday. Still wet in the southeast, wet for the northwest, but on into Sunday, and may still see some rain in the same locations and a chance of some scattered storms. Maybe a little brighter weekend for us. In the northeast, we'll do okay at around the Providence, Hartford, even Boston. Chance of some rain, but again, maybe some isolated rain, not a soaking rain like we've seen the last few weekends here. Northwest could get soaked a little, which is a good thing. We need the rain. Also, the Ohio and Tennessee Valley, even on toward Philly, rainfall lingers, heading back to work on Monday. Take a look at the temperatures across the area with the big ridge in place, and then, of course, the trough kind of working through, some cooler air behind our front pushing through. A little cooler air. Just a smidgen cooler in toward our Thursday. Chicago, Indianapolis, Detroit, cooling nicely. Even New England getting a little cooler, not a lot, but a bit. Then temperatures start to moderate quite a bit. A lot of warmth across the southwest. We'll start to kind of move it up, though, with the temperatures warming around Chicago on toward the weekend. Overnight lows, pretty much, obviously, the same progression. Milder air in place. A little cool air moving across the northern plains and across the Midwest, but eventually that, too, will change as conditions again, moderate just a little. Some cool air across the interior west. Otherwise, pretty mild time. Waking up to the 50s on Saturday morning around Chicagoland, looking at a pretty mild start. As far as temperatures coast to coast, that's a look at the week. We need to talk about some short-term concerns. Also look at the implication of weather and your health coming up in a few moments. We'll discuss this stormy spot in particular next, right after your local forecast. Please just stay tuned.
May I help you, sir?